Welcome to the Ultimate Data Structure Series. My name is Mosh Hamedani, and I'm going to be your instructor in this series. Let me explain in 3 minutes how I've structured this course and how we can get the most out of it. This video is super important, so make sure to watch it to the end. This course is the first part of my Ultimate Data Structure Series, where we talk about linear data structures such as arrays, linked lists, stacks, queues, and hash tables. We'll talk about the nonlinear data structures such as trees and graphs in part 2. This series is for computer science students whose lecturers failed at explaining these concepts, or anyone who's preparing for a job interview. A lot of companies, especially big companies like Google, Microsoft, and Amazon, ask data structure and algorithm questions in their interviews to see if you know how to think like a programmer. The materials in this series will change how you think about coding. They teach you how to think like a programmer and design fast and scalable algorithms. This course is the first step. In this series, I'll be using Java because that's a universally understood language, but you can use any language you're familiar with because our focus is on data structures and algorithms, not programming languages. If you don't know Java, you can watch the first part of my Java series. If you're a C# developer, you can get started immediately because Java and C# are very similar. Also, I'll be using IntelliJ as my IDE, which you can download from jetbrains.com, but you can use any code editor you're comfortable with. Our focus is on algorithm design, not tooling. Now, this course is a bit different from my other courses where you watch the videos and learn new things. In this course, you have to solve problems, a lot of problems, and that's how you will learn the art of problem solving. All the exercises you see in this course are popular interview questions. These are the exercises that teach you how to think like a programmer. So every single one of them is important. Some of these exercises might be a bit challenging. Do not quickly jump to my solution. Do your best to solve the problem on your own. What matters is that you spend time thinking about various ways to solve a problem. This process will activate certain parts of your brain, and that's what matters, not the solution. If you can't complete the exercise in a timely manner, that's perfectly fine. Don't get disappointed. You're a student of this course, so you're learning. If you could complete every exercise immediately, you wouldn't be taking this course, right? So here's the bottom line. This course is going to change how you think about programming. You will learn how to solve problems and write beautiful code like a professional software engineer. I worked really hard for this course to be the ultimate data structure course in the world, and I hope you think that too. So let me know your thoughts on Twitter. I cannot wait to hear what you think. Now let's jump in and get started.